Hello students, so let's start with second chapter, Rise of New Kingdoms. In the last class or in the last chapter, we saw about the middle centuries. How can we know about them? So that is through inscriptions or through monuments or through manuscripts or books. So now we will learn about this in detail. Can you tell me from where till where did middle ages, middle medieval period existed? Okay, so let's start. A number of powerful kingdoms existed in India during the early medieval period, that is from 700 AD to 1200 AD. The Rajputs gained control in the north, and the other powerful kingdoms were those of Palas and in Bengal, that is present day West Bengal, Jharkhand and Bihar. The Rashtrakutas, along with some small kingdoms in the Deccan and Cholas in the south. Mohammed of Ghazni and Mohammed Ghori, who were basically invaders from the northwest, also had an important role to play during the early medieval period. In fact, the south saw the emergence of powerful dynasties like the Pallavas, Pandyas and the Cholas. But these small kingdoms continuously fought with each other to extend their control over their neighboring territories. So we know that many powerful kingdoms existed in the early medieval period. For example, in north, Rajputs gained the control over the other kingdoms of Palas in Bengal. That is, at that time it was Bengal. If we consider it with present time, it is West Bengal, Jharkhand and Bihar. Then there were Rashtrakutas who ruled in the Deccan. Deccan is basically in the south. And then Cholas in the south. There is difference Deccan and then comes the south. Even Mahmud of Ghazni. Ghazni is area in Afghanistan who came and invaded India during the time of... Yes, you should know. We studied this in the last chapter. And then Mohammed Ghori. These were basically the invaders who also affected the northwest area. And they had very important role to play in the early medieval period. In south, then slowly and gradually, many dynasties emerged like Pallavas, Pandyas and Cholas. Basically, these were small dynasties, but they continuously fought with each other to gain control over the neighboring areas. Okay, just a second. Okay. Now, studying about North India. Origin of Rajputs. We saw that Rajputs gained control in the North, but how did they came into existence? The word Rajput has its origin in the Sanskrit language. It comes from the word Rajputra, which means the son of a king or a ruler in Sanskrit. So, the word is derived from the Sanskrit word Rajputra, that is the son, putra is a son and Raj is of a king or ruler. So son of a king or a ruler, that is in Sanskrit. Historians and scholars differ about the lineage of the Rajputs, from where do they derive or who were their ancestors. Historians and scholars, they have different opinions. Some scholars believe that Rajputs were the descendants of Central Asian tribes. These tribes settled in India after the Hun invasion. You might have studied about the Hun invasion that happened in ancient India, ancient times. So some scholars believe that Rajputs were the descendants. They were the generations to generations that were passed from the Central Asian tribes who came and settled in India. But most of the scholars agree that they belong to Kshatriyan clan. Some Rajputs call themselves Suryavanshi, that is belonging to the sun family. Others call themselves as Chandravanshi, that is belonging to the moon family. However, four Rajput clans considered themselves to be part of fire family, that is Agnikul. They believe that they were born of a holy sacrificial fire. These four clans were Pratihars, Chauhans, Solankis and Parmars. So Kshatriyan, as we saw that some scholars believe that they were descendants of Central Asia, whereas most of the scholars agree that they belong to Kshatriya clan. Now Kshatriya are basically the warriors Then amongst this, even there were partitions because some Rajputs believe that they were Suryavanshi, that who directly belonged to the family of sun god. Some believe that they were Chandravanshi, who belonged to the family of moon. And basically then there were four Rajput clans or four Rajput dynasties who believed that they belonged to fire family, that is Agni Kul. They believed that they were born out of fire, that is a holy sacrificial fire. And they believed, and they were four clans, Pratihars, Chauhans, that is Chahmanas, Solankis, and the Pawars or Parmars. The Tomars, the Gadhwals, and the Chandelas were the three important Rajput clan, who along with the four belonging to Agni Kul clan were the rulers during medieval times. So here we come to know basically of many tribes of Kshatriya clan, some who belong to Kshatriya, some who said that they were from Suryavanshi, some believe that they were Chandravanshi, some believe that they were Agni Kul. Those four who belong to Agni Kul were Pratihars, Chauhans, Solankis and Parmars. And then there were other three clans who even belong to Agni Kul and they were important rulers in the medieval time. They are Tomar, Gadhwals and Chandels. Okay, so the Rajputs dominated northern India from about 750 AD to 1000 AD. Most of the rulers were the followers of Hinduism. So this can be asked in one mark, from where to where Rajputs dominated and which religion did they follow. So we'll study about each and everyone in detail, starting with the Tomars. The city of Dillika, that is Delhi, was founded by Tomar rulers in the 8th century. Later the Chauhans controlled their territories. It is said that the city of Dillika, that is situated in Delhi, was founded by the Tomar rulers in the 8th century, and later Chauhans controlled it. So now moving to next tribe, that is Chauhans. Chauhans ruled the areas of Delhi and Ajmer. They were also known as Chahmanas, and Prithviraj Chauhan was the most powerful ruler, Chauhan ruler. We all know Prithviraj Chauhan. Yes, he belonged to this Chauhan dynasty. The Chauhan ruled around the areas of Delhi and Ajmer, present day Delhi and Ajmer. They were also known as Chahmanas. So either they will ask you with the Chahmanas name or Chauhans, both are same. And the most famous ruler of the Chauhan dynasty was Prithviraj Chauhan. Chand Bardai, popular epic poem, the Prithviraj Raso, tells us about his valor and his fight with Mohammed Ghori. Chand Bardai is the author who wrote the popular epic poem, that is Prithviraj Raso. This poem is very famous, and this poem tells us about his valor, that is his aggressive fight with Mohammed Ghori. Mohammed Ghori came to India in 1991. At that time, Prithviraj Chauhan defeated him once, and then Mohammed Ghori had to flew back to his hometown. Again in 1191, he came, he was defeated and he left. Again in 1192, Mohammed Ghori came and he defeated Prithviraj Chauhan, where Prithviraj Chauhan died. Moving forward to the next dynasty, the Solankis. The Solankis of Gujarat were popularly known as the Chalukyas of Gujarat. Sidraj was the most powerful Solanki ruler. Solankis, basically they ruled from Gujarat. They were popularly known as Chalukyas of Gujarat. Chalukyas were basically the dynasties of south, but it was very powerful and he has done many good things for the people of Gujarat. So he was known as Chalukyas of Gujarat, and Sidraj was the most powerful ruler, Solanki ruler. Remember the powerful rulers of each and every dynasty. Gujarat was a major center of Indian Ocean trade, and Anhilwara was one of the largest cities during those times. Anhilwara, that is basically now known as Patan. So Gujarat at that time was famous for trade because trade was carried out from Indian Ocean, and Gujarat was the major center, and Anhilwara was one of the largest cities of those times. The Solankis gave the great patrons of art and architecture. Solanki ruler built magnificent temples. The Dilwara Temple at Mount Abu and the Sun Temple of Modera were built by them. Remember the famous work? I hope, or I guess that you have been to Mount Abu, the Dilwara temples. They were built by the Solankis, and even Sun Temple of Modera was built by Solankis. Moving forward to next dynasty is the Parmars, or they were also known as Pawars. The Parmar were famous ruler who established their kingdom in the region around Malwa. So can you tell me where is Malwa? It is in the Central Asia. The capital of Parmars was at Dhar. Bhoj Parmar was the famous most powerful ruler. The famous Nilkantheshwar temple at Udaipur was built by Parmars. Remember the important ruler? That is Bhoj Parmar. And also remember the famous work, that is Nilkantheshwar temple at Udaipur, was built by the Parmar dynasties. Gadwals. Jayachandra was the king of Gadwals. The Gadwals ruled the region around Kannauj. Kannauj is in? Can you tell me? Okay. In 1194 AD, Mohammad Ghori defeated Gadwal king Jayachandra. So famous rule, Jayachandra ruler, he ruled from the region around Kannauj. In 1194, Mohammad Ghori defeated Gadwal king Jayachandra. In 1192, Mohammad Ghori defeated Prithviraj Chauhan, and 1194 he defeated Gadwal king Jayachandra. It is believed that this is wonderful fact to know. It is believed that there were 36 Rajput families. Among them, four claimed a special position: Pratihars, Chamanas or Chauhans, Solankis and Parmars. They all belong to Agnikund. They came out of the sacred fire near Mount Abu in Rajasthan. So they were also regarded as the Agni Kul Rajputs. Moving forward, Chandelas of Bundelkhand. I hope, or I guess you have you might have heard the stories about Bundelkhand, and you might have also heard it in the movies. The Chandelas rule around Bundelkhand. That's an area. Kirti Varman was the most powerful Chandela ruler. Khajurao, that is in MP, Madhya Pradesh, was the capital city of Chandela rulers, and it consists of many beautiful temples constructed by Chandelas. Even if you go today, you can find many beautiful temples that were constructed by rulers of Chandel. So the most powerful ruler is Kirti Varman. Khajurao is their capital city, and it consists of many beautiful temples constructed by the Chandelas. You have to write all the important points that we have discussed here in your notebook and send me the photographs. We will discuss further in the next class. Thank you.